Our text, Isaiah 43 verse 2. Though you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, nor shall the flame scorch you. Our heading, infinite protection. Our text exhibits a child of God under the severest pressure and shows us the difference between him and a man of the world. A man of the world under the same conditions would have been driven to despair, and in that desperation would have become joylessly sullen or defiantly rebellious, falling into depression. First, here you see what a child of God takes the place of desperation. When others despair, he trusts in God. When he has nowhere to look, he turns to his heavenly Father. And when for a time, even in looking to God, he meets with no conscious comfort, he waits in the patience of hope, calmly expecting aid and resolving that even if he does not come, he will cling to God with all the energy of his soul. Here all the man's courage comes to the front, not as in the case of the ungodly, obstinately to rebel, but bravely to confide. Secondly, the child of God is courageous, for he knows how to trust. His heart says, "Yes, Lord, it is bad with me now, and it is getting worse. But should the worst come to the worst, still I will cling to you and never let you go." In what better way can the believer reveal his loyalty to his Lord? He evidently follows his master, not in fair weather only, but in the foulest and roughest ways. He loves his Lord, not only when he smiles upon him, but when he frowns. His love is not purchased by the largeness of his Lord's golden hand, for it is not destroyed by the smitings of his heavy rod. Though my Lord put on his sternest look, though from fierce looks he should go to cutting words, and though from terrible words he should proceed to cruel blows, which seem to beat the very life out of my soul. Yes, though he take down the sword and threaten to execute me therewith, yet in my heart steadfastly set upon one resolve, namely, to bear witness that he is infinitely good and just. Application. I have not a word to say against him, nor a thought to think against him. Much less would I wander from him. What shall we then say? Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution? I pray. Father God, thank you that we have in Jesus Christ the anchor of our souls. In his name, amen.